nog steeds een sfeerimpressie hier op de Dynamo 1996 editie.
This is Sam Dyche again.
Yes, this is Chris Caffrey here in the freezing rain, Dynamo 1996, is it? Why? Oh. I'm already, this umbrella's not working.
It's still working now.
Yeah, it's working now, but I was wet before I got under it, so.
Okay. Yeah. It's okay in the show Wet and Wild.
It's alright, it's wet and wild, and this is fun. I'm having fun.
How is it going with you?
We're back in Europe for the second time this year, and after this we're going into France and back into Germany to do summer metal meetings, and over to Japan. We're just busy. Still going.
You did a sun tour?
Excuse me?
You did a sun tour?
Oh, well, in America, there is sun. Which I've discovered that there's no sun in Europe. Not that I don't mind, but it doesn't do too good for my tan.
How's it going with Savadash overall in the world?
Everywhere it's going great. It's better and better all the time. Especially thanks to people like, you know, you guys and all people that work for our record companies. It's really coming all together. I mean, Savadash is just getting bigger and bigger and bigger, so it's been great.
It's your first time at Dynamo?
It's my first time playing Dynamo. It's Savadash's second time. They played back in 1988 or 87, I believe it was, and I'm excited. Everybody's a little wet, but I'm happy.
My time is up, and maybe you can do some interviews for us.
All right, yeah, I'm going to go around and talk to some people and see if they like the weather as much as I do.
Okay, so give me the microphone here.
All right,
we'll see you later.
I got the microphone and the umbrella.
I'm a little dead with the dead.
while escaping the appalling weather conditions here at Dynamo 96. And as you can see, we're now on a tour bus, and I love coming on these buses. I find them really peaceful and relaxing away from the crowds out there. And we've been invited on the tour bus by Savatage, making a welcome return to the show. And as you can see, I've got Zach and Chris joining me on the bus. So nice to have you guys back on the show. And I was just wondering if we could backtrack a little bit, because we haven't spoken for a long time. After the tragic death of Chris, I was wondering, was there any possibility that Savatage would split up, or why did you want to keep going?
Well, of course, when anything like that happens, you know, there's probably going to be thoughts of, wow, what do you do from here? You know, I'm sure 2 or 3 months after that, we were like that, and but we decided that, you know, knowing Chris and knowing his love for music, the one thing we couldn't do was let him down by not allowing his music to get out and not making more music so that his legacy could live on, and that's pretty much what's kept us going up to this point.
It's a good feeling. I know things are right, and John's back around, and it just, with the Aliva there, it keeps the spirit of that alive. So, and fans haven't been disappointed, like I said before, and Zach is up there, and Johnny's there, and I've been there on and off for 8.5 years, so there's a good family feeling there now. So
that's great. That's really, really important. So the new album is Dead Winter Dead.
Right.
And now this, I understand, was inspired after you saw some footage of the war in Yugoslavia.
Right. The former Yugoslavia, the breakup, the whole thing that hit the news. We were doing actually the Handful of Rain album, and that's when it really started over there. I think April of 91, thereabouts. And, you know, we just couldn't believe all the... Everybody just getting shelled left and right. They didn't care if it was a kid, a middle-aged person, an old person. They would just try to basically pick off anybody they could, going to try to get, you know, life-sustaining water, food. People had to live in their basements for up to years. Mm-hmm. And just really horrible the way that, you know, the world could allow this to go on. And even in the United States, we saw that the media was really holding back on information that every day you could just see tons of atrocities, but yet they don't want to show it because they don't want the Americans to feel guilty through the guilt, you know, through the American media.
I could pick up a newspaper in my hometown, and there'd be like, okay, you know, cow runs across street, crushes mailbox, and a big headline, and then there'd be like, you know, 25,000 people killed in shellings in the last month on a little tiny thing.
So the whole thing was really, really, you know, given a low key to what it really was, and we just thought that, man, I mean, this is just crazy. The more and more we read about it, we got few books, and you know, you grab as much, you know, literature as you can, and the more and more we read, we said, man, I think we should just, if anything, why can't we devote some time to this subject? If the American media is not going to do it, why can't we just do a concept album about it, and at least show people that we wanted to look into the issue,
right?
And we're not going to sit back there and digest whatever they want to feed out to us, just digest a bunch of crap.
Well, that sounds pretty harrowing stuff, and unfortunately we don't have time to talk about it some more, but hopefully we can catch you again and talk more in depth about the new record, because it sounds like there is a lot to talk about on that. So you're going to do some more dates in Europe?
Sure, yeah. We're going to do the Summer Metal Meetings.
Awesome.
I think that's what it's called.
Summer Metal
With the rest of the guys, the rest of the bands there. I think that's about 6 or 7 shows. We're going to France for the first time. We're doing a whole week, about 7 shows in France for the first time. We're going to break in there and show everybody that we're live and kicking over there.
Good.
Going to Italy, then we're going over to Japan for a little while.
Excellent. Up Japan.
Okay, well, I wish you lots of luck with the new album and all the touring, and have fun at Dynamo here. And yeah, indeed, and don't get too wet. Stay dry. All right, lovely to have Savatage back, and right now we're going to check them out live on stage here at Dynamo 96. Let's see how they got on.
Where this all has led. Captain Patrick.